Hello, hello, my lovely ladies. Welcome to my channel and welcome to a new Will I Buy It video where I am going to go through all the new makeup releases from high-end and indie brands and I'm going to see if I want to pick them up, yes or no. This is a video that is based on the series by Samantha March. She has a Will I Buy It series and she also has a community playlist where a lot of other creators leave these type of videos so you can watch them and see what a lot of other creators are thinking about these new makeup releases, which is a lot of fun because there are anti-hauls where people are focusing on drugstore, indie, high-end, luxury, so check that out. It's very fun. It's down in my description box. Also, I have put all the Instagram accounts I use to get my information. I put all of them down below in the description box. I would highly suggest you follow them on Instagram. All right, and without further ado, let's jump into the video. If this is your first time here, welcome. My name is Anne-Chris and on my channel I want to give you some inspiration on how to play with those fun indie makeup and all those colors but keep your looks a little bit more sophisticated and elegant. I also try out a lot of new makeup, especially from those high-end and indie brands, so I can also tell you what is good and what is not. So if you need some inspiration on how to keep your colorful looks a little less loud and you want to know what is good from high-end and indie brands, then please consider subscribing because I upload 2 to 3 times a week. So there's always something fun to watch. All right, I have a lot to go through, but I always have that because, you know, I film these like every 2 to 3 weeks. I used to do them every week, but it got a little bit much. So I'm going to try and keep this a little bit short. I'm going to start off with the new Glam Light palette. It is the Ice Cream Dream palette. It's going to be $45 and it's going to launch on the 12th of September. And I am going to definitely try to get it. I don't know if I'm going to try to get it on launch day, but I really want to try out Glam Light. And these colors are so much fun. They are so cute. The only thing I want to say is that I think that the section on the right is very orange. But I have to see for myself and I really want to try Glam Light. I really love those colorful shades and the colors are so cute. So cute. But what I love is that it's also got a lot of darker shades, but it also got a lot of lighter shades. So you got a palette that is very colorful, but it goes from light to darker. So you can make those looks a little bit more, you know, complete. And I do love that in a palette. Go from light to dark, not too many shimmers. And this is a good one. This has a lot of shimmers, but it also has a lot of matte. So I love that. I like a ratio that it has a little bit more or at least half of the shades matte. So yeah, this is definitely coming to me. I don't know if I'm going to get it quickly, but I will get it. Then from Dior, we have some new Backstage Glow face palettes. I believe there are already 2 or 3 out. And I really want to get the one with the peach shade. So that's like in the original releases. But now you have 3 new ones. You have like a more pinky one, a more goldeny one, and a more bronzy one. I think they all look really nice. But I think they are catered to like more types of skin tones. So they're not necessarily totally for me. Maybe the pink one. But I think that goldeny one has too many like lighter shades. And that gold shade I can't wear. And the deeper one is just too deep for me. But you know, it's a good thing that they are extending the range. So a lot more people can try those face palettes. I don't own one. But I've heard great things about the quality. So I really... I think it's really cool that they are expanding on that. And one day I will get that one with the peach in it. One day. Hourglass has revealed their new upcoming holiday palette. Once again, we have 2. We have a 6-pen and we have a 4-pen. And you have the like limited edition lipsticks. I think pricing was like $80 and $60 or $65 for the smaller one last year. I don't know for sure. It is launching on the 9th of September on their website. I don't know when it's coming to retailers. I don't see any information. I don't see any pricing. But my gosh, I am really going to try and get these. I know that now Hourglass is stocked in the Bijenkorf in Holland. They don't go as fast here in Holland. So I am going to wait a little bit because I saw that like that Ghost palette from last year was available for a very long time here in Holland. So that is a good thing. I don't have to jump on it right away. I don't like to do that. And I am not really sure on which one I will get, but I think I will go for the bigger one because you have like more shades and I think all of the shades look very pretty. But I also think that the small one looks nice, but I'm not going to get both. You know, that would be really redundant. But yeah, the big one is screaming to me big time. Then Hip Dot has released two new nude eyeshadow palettes. One is Witchy Warms and the other is Mystic Mauve. So you have like a more mauve, cooler toned one and you have a warmer toned one. Very nice, very cute, very nice for summer. I really like the packaging. They are $22 US for the one and $40 for the bundle. And I think they look really cute. The swatches also look really nice. I'm just not going to get them because, you know, it's like I have these shades a million times over. And I do love colorful palette a little bit more than like neutrals, but it doesn't look bad. I've never used Hip Dot. If you did, then please let us know down below in the comments what the quality is like. But I think they look cute. They look cute. It's just not for me. I'm going to pass it on. Or pass it on. I'm going to pass on it. Alright, I have two things from Too Faced because they have revealed their holiday collection for 2020. It's like very much like foxy and doggy themed. It looks cute, but you know, Too Faced is not really a brand I go for. I have had like one palette from them, eyeshadow palette, and I didn't enjoy that one. It's the Pretty Rich palette. I didn't really like it, so I'm not going to go out and get this. Just know that it's there. I see blushes with highlighters. I see two palettes. I think there is going to be a shitload more than just this, but this is the first thing they have shown. And also, they are going to release a palette that it's called Mariale Amor Caliente. I don't know. I think I butchered that, but it's on the screen. You know what it looks like. It is very pink gold with peaches and neutral colors. It looks really nice. It is a collaboration with Mariale. I don't know him or her, so I'm sorry. But it's launching on the 20th of September for $42 on Ulta Beauty. So I don't know if it's Ulta exclusive. It is what it is. I'm not going to get this because it's Too Faced. I don't need Too Faced. And I really need to hunt this one down. I'm not going to do that. So, but you know it's there. If you live in the States and you have access to Ulta and you think this is a beautiful color story, I do think it's a nice color story. It's just that I already have it. Then, you know, it's there. It's there. I think that $42 is a little steep though. But, you know, you do you, boo. Then from Milk Makeup, they are launching their Hydro Grip Setting and Refresh Spray. It's an alcohol-free dual face setting and refreshing spray that sets makeup for up to 12 hours. All right, it's already launched because it launched on the 2nd of September and it is $36 US. You can get it at Sephora and Milk Makeup. This is, I think, an extension on their Hydro Grip line because they already had that primer. I've never used it, but I've heard great things about it. I really want to try them, but Nikki told me I should start with the Makeup Revolution one first. So I might, even though I'm not really a drugstore person. We'll see. But you know, if Nikki is saying I have to do something, I should do it. So yeah. But this looks really interesting. The only thing I am like a bit curious about is that the Hydro Grip primer is very sticky and very grippy. And what is going to happen with this then? I'm really, really curious because it does say that it hydrates. It's a visible, breathable, glossy glow. So it sounds to me like this is going to be more of like a skincare type of deal. And my experience with setting sprays that have a lot of skincare ingredients in there is that they are quite tacky and sticky and they don't dry down. So I'm wearing the Charlotte Tilbury at the moment. It's beautifully dried down. Doesn't feel like hairspray on the skin. But yeah, so I really love that one. And I don't love it when it's sticky. I have that matcha one. It's technically a skincare product and it is a little bit more sticky. So I'm very curious to hear about, you know, people trying this out. Then Jouer, they are launching their new Blush and Bloom Cheek Plus Lip Duos. Very long name. It's a multi-use creamy product that you can use on your lips and on your cheeks. You have three shades Uplift Duo, Celebrate Duo and Inspire Duo. It's going to launch on the 15th of September for $32 on Sephora, Beautylish and Beauty Bay. Oh, that's a good thing. It's coming to Beauty Bay on the same time. So that is very nice. I must say, I am intrigued. I do love Jouer products. I have the bronzer and I have a blush duo. Love them. Very stunning quality. So I really want to try these out because I am getting into more of like cream products. I really love that. All the shades look like shades I would wear. Maybe not the lightest one, because I don't know, especially that really light one. The like one of the one side is quite pinky and the other one is almost like a nude peach. I don't know if that will show up on my skin tone, but you know, it's a good thing that it goes that far for fair skin. And the other one, the darker one, I think I can make work, and it looks really, really beautiful. And especially the middle one, because you know, like a coral, watermelon, bring it on. I love it. I love a very like out there blush. I'm not wearing an out there blush today. I'm wearing a Chanel Elegance today. But I do love it when it has some pigment to it and you can get that really flushed color. So I think I'm going to put these on the wishlist because they look really, really beautiful. Then Fenty has revealed their holiday pack. They have like four little gloss balm shades in one pack. They did one last year and I think they did one the year before that, but I don't know for sure, but I think so. And they have a new holiday pack and you have like a plummy color, a deep gold color, a coral color, and more of a champagne. And it looks really nice. If I can get it, if I can order it from France, the France Sephora, I might get it. Or because, let me see, it's coming the 14th of September. It is going to retail for $36. And you can also get two Stunners Mini Longwear Fluid Lip Color Duo. So is that, what is that? Is that something else? Oh, right. They also have like that more opaque color. And you can get two, like a very red one and a deep pink one. And those are going to be $25. And they are also coming the 14th of September. I am going to Sweden at the end of the week. I will be there for 3 weeks. And we're going to go to Stockholm as well. And there is a Sephora in Stockholm, so I'm going to see if I can get it there. And I won't pick up the duo, but I think I will pick up that like quad of or that mini gloss balm collection, because it looks really nice and I really do love the gloss balm formula. So that's there. Then from KVD Vegan Beauty, we have a new palette. It's coming in October 2020 to Ulta and Sephora. And it's a palette filled with 14 pixel perfect, sure, vegan pigments, including shimmers that can be used wet or dry. Well, that's not very revolutionary. You don't need to tell us. We can always use, yeah. So yeah, it's a 14 shade eyeshadow palette. I think the outside packaging looks I am such a sucker for packaging. I'm such a sucker for like that beautiful inlays, like retro, renaissance-y type of deal. If I could turn you around, you would see like these very big peacocks on my wall. I have wallpaper in that like duck eggshell color and then with these giant peacocks on there. I will link my beauty room makeover video. You can see it. So I love this style. I love it. The only thing is that I'm not really intrigued about the inside because there are like 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 shimmers and like 5 complementary matte shades. And I'm not about that life. I think it is very, very good for holidays because you tend to wear like more glittery shades on New Year's with Christmas and you have like these 5 shades to ground the look and then combine it with the shimmer. So it's a smart one. It's just, it's not for me. I don't really enjoy having that many shimmers because I do love to sometimes create a beautiful only matte look. And I can't get that out of this palette. So yeah. Nope, it's a no for me. Then we are going over to Natasha Denona because she has revealed her glam palette. This is a 15 pen palette. It's very cool toned, extremely cool toned. And it's based on like the Glam Light mini she had and she extended it to a big one. Usually she does it the other way around. She has a bigger one and then she does a mini, but now she did it like that. So very nice. It is in that midi type of format. So it's like the same as the Love palette, the Bronze palette and the Sunrise palette, I want to say. And it's $65. It's already out. You can get it on, I think, in American Sephora. You can get it on Selfridges for a while. I hope it's still there. But it's rolling out and it's coming to stores. Like at the end of September, everybody will be able to get this. I have seen a few people already reviewing this. I've seen Michelle Wong's video and I've already seen Just Glow Firefly puts a video up, and I saw, I think, who did I see? Charlotte Holdcroft, I think. I will link some videos down below if I can still find them, if you want to see how this is performing. I must say, I am still a little bit on the fence if I want to get this, because it looks a lot of, it does remind me a lot of the Sultry palette from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and it only has 5 mattes in here, and you know what I'm like about mattes and shimmer shades. I love shimmer shades, but I want more mattes, or at least half of the palette to be matte shades. But on the other hand, I do love the shimmer formula from Natasha Denona. And I feel like the palettes I already have don't have like very nice, really light shimmer shades. But to get a full palette, just to get some more shimmer shades, I'm still on the fence. Also, I think that in the swatches, it looks like a lot of... I don't have swatches here, but I've seen them in the videos, that a lot of shades are looking a little bit too much samey. So, but it's like in a $65 format. So I might wait until I can get this on sale. Black Friday is coming, stuff like that. So I might get it on sale. I'm not going to go and run out and get it unless you want my opinion on it, and I will buy it. But if you're like, girl, I'm just going to watch someone else, then... by all means, do that. But I would have loved to see a little bit more mattes in here and a little less redundancy. I have seen Beauty News talking about like the fact that this could be very nice and complementary to the Bronze palette, because a Bronze palette is very bronze, very gold, very orange, and this could ground it a little bit more. So if you have the Bronze palette and you want something to ground it, then this could be it. There were some people speculating if this is going to be a holiday release for her. I don't think so. I don't know why I'm basing this on, but it's like, I think she's going to release something that is like more of a collection with maybe some other complementary products as well. So I don't think this is like the definite holiday release. I think this is just a fall release and maybe a little bit pushed back because of COVID, but I don't know for sure. I've never I haven't heard anyone talking about anything else. The only thing I heard is that some people were saying, and I don't know if it's coming from her, but that she said that she's going to release a very colorful palette as well, but it's probably coming next year, so maybe that is like a spring type of deal. So that is on the Natasha Denona Glam palette. I do like the look of it. I think it's a bit shimmer heavy. I think there's some redundancy in here, and I'm not going to get it right away unless you want me to review it. But yeah, you have to leave me a comment saying that. Then I saw 2 highlighters from Juno & Co. Not by any means a new release. This is already out. They are... I don't see anything about pricing, but you can already get them on Juno.com. Or Junko.com. But I saw someone swatching them or using them. I don't know, but they looked so stunning. Like that, really. I'm wearing the Infinity highlighter from Linda Hallback at the moment, and I love that like glow from within type of highlight. And it looks like these are the type that are going to do that. So that is why I wanted to show you, because they looked stunning. Stunning. And I do think the shades are very pretty as well. I don't know anything about pricing, but I just wanted to let you know that they're there. Then NARS is expanding on their Climax range. cringe heavy, but you know, Climax range. They are going to release a new mascara and they have an eyeshadow palette. The eyeshadow palette is going to be $59, or is, because it's already launched. And the Climax Extreme Mascara is $24. I saw a lot of people already trying that mascara and liking it. So I'm very curious about it because I have the red one and I do like it, but it's not my perfect mascara by any means. But this one sounded a little bit more like a drier formula and a little bit more volumizing than the one in the red. So I am very curious about this. The eyeshadow palette I think looks nice. It's very fall appropriate with the reds and the burgundy purples with the golds. It looks like you can make a very beautiful look out of this, a few beautiful looks out of this. It's versatile. It goes from light to dark, which I really love because I think it's important that you can make, that you have both, that you have very light shades that you can use as a highlight and you can have some darker shades that you can use like to ground the look. The only thing is that I think it's a little weird. I will put up the swatches as well. You see that there's a black in here, and if you see the swatches, it looks a lot more like versatile and more of an interesting color story than you see like on the picture of the palette itself. So they really should do something about their marketing pictures, because it's not selling me with the marketing pictures. It is with the swatches. So it looks really nice. I just don't think I'm going to spend $59 on this one because it's not my perfect color story, even though I love the corals. I might. I have to swatch it. I don't know for sure. I am going to try that Climax mascara because you can get it in a mini. So I'm going to try if I can get the mini and I'm going to see if I like it. Then from Kaleidos, they have a new collection and it's huge. They have a lot of stuff. It's, what is it called? I don't know what it's called. It has a name. It has a name. And I already saw Debbie from Vinyl Beauty and Angelica Nykvist have videos on these. So I'll link them down below. I must say, I really like this collection. That suitcase looks so cute. So I wish I get PR from Kaleidos because I love the brand. But also they do these packages so cute. So I really would love to get the PR package. They have two new eyeshadow palettes. It's a pink one. It's a purple one and a nude one. Both of them look really nice. They have three shades in a highlight and contour bronze palette. So you have like three colors, two small ones and one bigger pan for the bronze in a light, medium and dark. So the lighter one is very cool toned and the medium is a little bit more warm and a deeper one as well. And then you have two new lip shades. Yeah. Sorry, I had to find some more information because I just had that one picture you're seeing right here. But they have three of those contour and highlight palettes. They have a cool and light, a warm and medium, and a warm and deep. That looks really deep. And they have a new lucid lip, like lip gloss type of deal. So I think that is all. There are no blushes or anything other than that. No, you have the two palettes, the face products and the lip gloss. And if you want to see some like reviews and some tutorials on it, or some, you know what I mean, I will link the videos down below where I saw some of my favorite creators doing that. So then the next thing is by Lethal Cosmetics. They have released bullet lipsticks and they're calling it the Affinity Collection, and they have 9 new lipstick shades. And I think this is the first time they have those bullet type lipsticks, and they look really, really beautiful. I have done a swatch video for the Proper Beauty lipsticks. I have 3. I did just filmed a swatch video. It will be up, I think, not next week but the week after that, so subscribe if you want to see that. And I think these look very pretty as well. I think what is very smart of them, they have swatched them on the skin tones they think are most suited to that color. So you have light, you have medium, you have deep, and they swatch them on lips of the colors they, or on the skin tones they think look the most flattering. I think they're stunning. They are truly nudes. The only one that stands out a little bit more, that stands out a little bit, that is what I want to say, is the color Arrival. It's a beige with warm undertones. It's very orange, and that is something you really have to like enjoy, that type of color. I think that the top two look very nice, and the fourth and the fifth one look really beautiful. So I might at some point pick them up. There are 16 euros. That's approximately $19. They're vegan and cruelty free and they have a natural satin finish. Very nice. I love that they are expanding on their range. Then a palette I thought looked really stunning is by Clarity Cosmetics. It's the Berry Royal palette. It's already launched. I don't know what the pricing is like, but I thought it looked really nice. It's like a, it looks a little bit like the very bold pink palette from Juvia's Place, but then just in like more variety. And then I have new products from Melt Cosmetics. They are already available and there are already some reviews up. If I can find some, I will link them down below. But they have, I don't really get what these are, but I think they're blushes and they're shimmery blushes. And I don't really know if that is something that is completely up my alley. Because I must say, I really love like just a, it can be a little luminous, but I don't want it to be glittery and I don't want it to emphasize texture. And it will on my skin because, yeah, I know, I don't really have like very smooth skin. It's getting better because I am using the Paula's Choice 2% BHA, the gray bottle. I'm using that and I'm already noticing some difference, but yeah, it's not something I really enjoy. I just like a matte blush or a little bit glow from within type of blush as I'm wearing right now and a nice highlight. So I'm a little bit on the fence if I want to get this, especially because they're $39, so they're not really cheap. You do get two products in one, so that's good. And I saw that the pans were quite large as well. So it looks really cool. Like the packaging from Melt, they do it outstanding. And I've heard great reviews on their highlights. So it might be just a beautiful launch. I just don't know if I want to get it. Then Chantecaille have revealed, no, launched, sorry, have launched their Safari Chic collection. It's an eye trio for $75. It's already sold out, I'm seeing here. And the lip veil is $48 in three shades. I hope they will bring back that eye trio because it looks really beautiful. And I also think that those lip veil colors look stunning. I love that like blushy, pinky, nude type of deal. And I am going to do a video on my collection. So I'm going to do a video on my lip collection, on my face product collection, and on my eyeshadow palettes, because I really need a declutter. I really do. But it's coming, I think, next month, because I'm going away for a few weeks on vacation. But I will come back and I will film that soon. And I feel like in my lip collection, I am missing like true nudes. So yeah, I think these look really beautiful. I like the fact that they're balmy. I am not someone who loves a very matte lipstick. I love them to be a little bit more creamy. And these look so stunning. I have seen Michelle Wong already do a like collection video on this. So if you want to see that, then check out Michelle Wong's video. I will link it down below. If I don't forget, I will have to link so much. I'll probably forget, but you know, it's there. It looked really, really stunning. It is expensive, but it's Chantecaille and part of these proceeds go to help the elephants. So that is very nice. And then the last thing is a new NARS foundation. It's the Soft Matte Complete Foundation. I think it is like an extension on their concealer. I don't know for sure, but I think that concealer is called Soft Matte as well. It's already launched. It's $40 and it's a matte foundation. This sounds like your skin is going to look as dry as the Sahara Desert, unless you have very oily skin. I saw Michelle Wong review this and it didn't look nice on her. It was way too dry and she has dry, sensitive skin. So I think for me, this is not going to work. If you have very oily skin, I know that Risa Does Makeup has quite oily skin. I don't know if she reviewed this. I hope she will. I hope she does. I hope she already has. Check out Risa Does Makeup. She has oily skin. And if she is reviewing this, then you can get a better idea of what this is going to be performing like. It's not a release I am going gaga over. It's just I wanted to let you know that it's there. If you have dry skin, I don't think this is going to be extremely suitable for you. But yeah. It's there. So if you are a NARS fan and you like a matte foundation, then please go and check it out. Okay, guys, that was it for me for this week. I will have all those videos listed down below. I hope I remember because it is a lot. but I will try to list them all down below. Thank you so much for watching. Please remember that everything always goes on sale at some point, so hold on to your horses and wait until something goes on sale, especially because there are no limited edition. I don't think there were any limited edition products I was talking about in this episode. If there were, then I will let you know, but I don't think there were, so please breathe, count to 10, and think if you really need it. Okay, guys, thank you so much. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye!